Wimpajamala man Walpa Thompson has proudly done his bit in the patchwork of stories through history that cover this beautiful land. His team has hosted what's believed to be the first major corroboree in the far west of New South Wales in 100 years.
You can't describe the feeling, but it just makes you feel solid inside, like full. It's a cup filling thing.
You think like a emu, you walk like an emu, you be an emu. Kangaroos, think about what kangaroos do.
They jump.
The mob are gathering today to bring back the culture, bring back the dance, bring back the music, bring back the song, bring back our song line.
Look at Kumi.
Last month, dance groups from Queensland, Victoria and across New South Wales descended on the Mutawintji National Park, the first in New South Wales owned and run by traditional owners for a two-day cultural festival.
And some of them, this is the first time those fellas have been here to sing and dance with us in our country.
It's about just enjoying the time that you're here, just taking it all in. You can feel, I feel warmth here.
In 1983, 40 years ago, the Barkindji people, led by William Bates, stood up and fought for their rights with a blockade of this newly created national park, upset that tourists were damaging and disrespecting sacred sites.
We blockaded the park to stop that stuff from happening, where people were going into the wrong place, talking about our families as if we were gone forever, when we're still here in the country. Still connected to the place.
The blockade planted the seed for the eventual transfer of the park to Aboriginal control 15 years later in 1998. Walpa Thompson is chair of the board that manages Mutawintji in partnership with the New South Wales National Parks and Wildlife Service. Now they are sharing their beautiful country in a profound way.
So once we tap back into it, that it feeds our souls, our hearts, our bodies, our minds, and we need it. So there's this yearning for it, and some of us that have had to struggle, because we think we're without, that struggle is actually a part of that story. And what we're doing here is we're also inviting non-Wimbitja into these things, but we're saying we'll share it with you so they can understand that struggle that people have gone through.
Chantal Thompson started a dance group 2 years ago and says the event was both powerful and healing.
In this very creek bed, there was cultural being practiced. It was being remembered and it was being shared. There was a lot of healing that happened last night, but it also ignited for a lot of our young ones. It planted that seed in them that this is their culture, that this is their responsibility, and that they are here to carry it, but they're not here to do it alone.
And it's not what we're doing isn't for us. It's for our grandkids. We're not doing this for us. Doing it for the country and doing it for those kids to come and doing it for our ancestors and our old people that fought for this place to be handed back.
Hey,